Hey everybody, welcome back to the Lab-RAT-ory. Dr. Cranky here, working double time. This is going to be probably a two, maybe three part clinic. So you wanna be able to stay tuned in. We are working, as I mentioned in the last video, last update video. We are working on weaponry. And so I wanted to walk you through some of what I do. And of course, the fun begins with Google image. In this case, we punched in a futuristic Gatling gun, and you're gonna have 1,000,003 pictures that'll make your head explode and all of that. So I went in and looked at maybe 2-3 pages of the stuff, got some ideas, in part because I never scratch build with the intention of replicating something that'll be an exact replica. We don't do that here in the laboratory, in part because we just can't. As much as we've tried, we can't do it. Over a period of a few years, you learn that that's what you need to do. Anyway, so that's the first step. Do your research and then keep a few pictures of elements that you love. Now, what are you going to need? Well, you are going to need lots and lots of styrene tubing, hex-shaped, square, C-shaped, I-shaped, you name it, okay? So that's sort of the beginning of what you're gonna keep in your stash. And, you know, we don't throw anything out here in the laboratory, as you've seen with the glimpse of our spare parts box, which we've shown you. And, you know, and the reason being that we like to scratch build things like that. That's the front grill or, you know, defense mechanism so that you bump into you know, those zombies, etc., etc. I always think about the folks like our good friend Barry Hasker, who's been doing this for a long time, but the folks who work in the Mad Max movies, how much fun they must be having and how hard they must be working, because they're doing the stuff 1-1. So the other thing that I wanted to tell you simply is that, you know, once again, you have to raid your parts box. This is something we've done for the headliner. This kind of, fresh air blower. And there's going to be some dials on here. And that's going to go right in here, which is why we have that pencil mark. Because this is going to go, the roll cage hits that part. And so we are going to, let me see if I can, there you go. And that's, you know, that's how it's going to look. And this is from a, from an engine, from the parts box, you know, and a little bit of scratch building. And so we made this and it put a big smile on our face. So the tools that we use, simple tools, mind you, you recognize this from the school days. And we like the one, this was, I think, 99 cents or 59 cents. You can, you know, but we like ours to have the little punch keeper. Okay. So it's as simple as taking your styrene and just coming in and punching these little circles, right? Now, a couple of things. This clinic is about scratch building a Gatling gun, but this is a powerful tool because you can, in fact, get a strange, you know, not strange circles out of it. But what I'm saying is you could do this very same thing on a piece of paper, which I should do. Let me see if I get a little card. Here we go. Yeah, this is an old card right here. Okay, so this is just a piece of card. So you come in and, you know, this is an old trick from our friends over in the military builders. Okay, we have to redo that. There we go. Okay, instant camel. A weird camel pattern, and you could do as many of these as you want, and so you could paint through it and get this kind of weird. That's not what we're gonna do to this Death Stalker, but I'm just walking you through all these old tips and techniques. So a hole puncher will in fact cut through not very thick, but maybe 20, you know, 10, 20, 30. Thick, and so, you know, it's great for doing all kinds of interesting things. Like, you know, I want to show you the gun. Probably I'm already at 6 minutes, so we'll do it in the next one, but there's a cut circle down there. So the other tool that is indispensable to us is, of course, a tube, miniature tube cutter. You can find these at your do-it-yourself stores or online. And so it's as simple as this, my friends. All right. So you can cut out gas tanks. You can cut out any kind of length of tubing, any size of tubing, because this will extend probably to about an inch and a half if you're lucky. So, you know, and you go dialing. If you don't have one of these tools in your arsenal, pick one up, because this is how we cut not only aluminum tubing, and also plastic tubing. So you go, you know, go slow and you go turning. You could turn the rod, which is what I tend to do, or you can do that, which is what plumbers do. And of course, we now lost the tubing, but I'll show you. I mean, that's basically it. And that's the tool right there. All right. So these two things and your X-Acto knife and some sanding sheets or sanding sticks and or glue and other stuff. That's all you need. Yeah, that's all you need for this kind of build. And that's pretty much it. We'll walk you through what we've done to this Gatling gun in the next round. All right, this one's gone on too long. So stay tuned in for part two. More Cranky Show coming up.